Successful story of Don Bosco matriculation higher secondary school Tirunelveli 1992 to 2020. The mission of schools is to develop a sense of truth, of what is good and beautiful. Pope Francis. To promote self-discipline in academic excellence and to mold persons in pursuance of making a better life for humanity through education.
Pleasant morning to our beloved Father Founder and Chairman Dr. J. A. Arul Raj. Dear fathers of MMI and all our sisters of DMI, we the sisters from Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Tirunelveli, feel proud and honored to present the journey of our institution, as we step into the 25th year, in envisioning the vision and mission of our founder, in the service of the student community, transforming dreams into reality of the students, and by achieving the global standards of our institution. The key to success is to focus on goals, not obstacles. To accomplish any great endeavor, you must start. The start of a new idea, to leave a footprint in the field of education, sprouted when we first placed the foot in Tirunelveli, to run an institution in the year 1991.
Origin of our school. Our institution is situated in St. Xavier's Colony, Tirunelveli, the Archdiocese of Palayamkottai. It is located in 1 kilometer away from the new bus stand. In the year 1991 May, we bought 4.33 acres of land to construct a school building. This land was an agricultural land till 1991. Reverend Father Dr. J. A. Arul Raj, our chairman and founder, had a plan to establish a matriculation school in Xavier's Colony, Tirunelveli. Our school was started in the name of Don Bosco Matriculation School in St. Xavier's Colony. The reason to take over this place is, in order to enlighten the backward children, especially the Muslims, where there is no development in giving the education to the children, there we have planned to give the education, to those particular children give excellent education, in and around Melapalayam Tirunelveli. We obtained the approval on 1994 in December. By the grace of God our Father and the support of our Founder Father, the co-foundress Mother Virgin, Sister Rita, the Superiors General, Mr. Cletus Babu, Mr. V. William and Mr. Ignatius Herman, who strive hard to get this land and to construct school for the well-being of the people in and around in Melapalayam area. On 02-12-1992 foundation was laid by Most Reverend S. Irudhaya Raj D.D., the Bishop of Palayamkottai, and blessed by Reverend Father Dr. J. A. Arul Raj, Founder and Chairman. St. Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School was established in the year 1994. The school was constructed for the well-being of the people in and around in Melapalayam area. Mr. Ignatius Herman was the first principal and Sister Lord Umeri, the first administrator, was appointed in the year 2nd December 1994. In the first year, on 6th of June 1994, we have started classes from LKG to 6th standard, with 6 classrooms for 99 children. Make future leaders of our nation. Aim of our school. To educate intellectually enlightened, spiritually profound, emotionally balanced, socially committed, morally responsible. St. Don Bosco admits the deserving children, irrespective of their social and economic status, and kept up its high standard and name. Curriculum. Regarding curriculum, Don Bosco School is following State Board Samashir syllabus from 1st to 12th standard. Evaluation process will be done by Comprehensive Continuous Evaluation Method, CCE pattern, up to 9th standard. Every month we used to conduct monthly test and 3 terminal examinations for all the classes.
Infrastructure. The school has state-of-the-art classrooms, new furniture, smart board arrangements to conduct classes using technology. The school has sophisticated library and science and computer lab. 2 floors beautiful building was constructed with 35 classrooms, 3 labs and 2 staff rooms. All the classrooms are equipped with good furniture and 29 classrooms are equipped with smart board, cameras in the classrooms and laboratories like physics, chemistry, biology and computer. We upgraded our school with latest technology for teaching and learning and satisfy the students and parents. Transport, we have transport facilities with good condition. 4 vans are flying to the nearest areas to pick up the children with safety measures. The school transport is available in all routes in and around the villages. Faculty, Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School, is well acclaimed for its dedicated and competent teaching faculty and caring supporting faculty. They mark the strength and pride of the institution. The management wishes to appreciate their service to the student community and to this institution. In the field of extracurricular activities, the platform has been expanded to explore the student potentials. Programs such as Bharatam, Yoga, Taekwondo, Music, Abacus and Silambam are taught to the students by professionals every week to enhance their fitness and defense skills. Education is the crown of life. Education helps the children to shape their life and mold their future. Therefore, we give importance to the children through education. We give first preference to discipline, next to the education. We organized seminar in order to develop the children in their character and behavior.
The purpose of education is to replace an empty mind with an opened eye and to support children in developing the skills, the knowledge, and the dispositions that will allow them to be responsible, contributing members of their community, to be a good friend, to be a good mate, to be able to work, and to contribute to the well-being of the community. It is create emotionally healthy, meaningful relationships among the students. In kindergarten classes, activity-based learning is given. Faith formation and moral classes are conducted for the students by our sisters. To reach our education to every student, we take special care and conduct coaching classes for the slow learners and for the students appearing board exam every day. To encourage creative thinking among children and to find their hidden talents, we conduct No Bag Day on every Saturday. It was conducted in our school very creatively.
Education is not the learning of facts, but the training of the mind to think, as rightly said by Albert Einstein. Education play in teachers' continuing professional development. Education is part of our mission. We usually focus on pre-service programs. When we have thought about in-service, we concentrate on the graduate programs we provide. Occasionally, we have offered workshops or special summer sessions and provide in-service program every year.
Teachers are born, not made. Since teaching is considered an art and a science, the teacher has to acquire not only knowledge, but also skills that are called tricks of the trade. Our DFT performs a significant function of providing learning experiences to lead their students from the darkness of ignorance to the light of knowledge. To create the value of encouraging teachers to work in groups, and the power of reaching teachers and involving them in the process of their own development. To invest in the preparation of teachers and motivate them, every year we organized several trainings to our staff. From DFT conducted many training programs to the southern schools.
On the 6th of June 2015 and 13th of June 2015, Mr. William conducted orientation program on teaching methodology for 60 teachers from various schools. Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Tirunelveli, St. Joseph International School, Rajapalayam, and St. Joseph International School, Aralvaimoji. On the 13th of June 2015, we conducted one-day training for southern schools in Don Bosco Matriculation School on technical way of teaching. On the 24th of May 2016, we conducted orientation program for the teachers from Don Bosco, Rajapalayam and Aralvaimoji. Totally 60 teachers are participated. Program coordinator, Mr. L. Xavier, special speaker, Mr. Anna Raja, principal, B.Ed. College of Education. On the 13th of August 2016, the academic coordinator, Mr. Xavier from DFT, conducted training for CBSE schools faculties at Don Bosco Matriculation School. They were teaching the usage of smart board. On the 15th of July 2017, workshop for all newly recruited staff and all the KG teachers, along with the principal, conducted at Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Tirunelveli. On the 28th of October 2017, in-service training program was conducted by the DFT, academic coordinator, Mr. Xavier and Mr. Jeshuraj Samuel, retired principal, Mumbai, conducted training for maths and science faculties. On the 4th of August 2018, Educom company organized program for all our teachers from Don Bosco. On the 6th of July 2019, Abacus training conducted for southern schools, for maths handling teachers, at Don Bosco School, Tirunelveli. On the 20th of July 2019, orientation program for KG faculties of DFT Southern Schools, conducted by Mr. T. Arokya Raja, training coordinator from DFT. On the 13th of March 2020, a special program was conducted by the principal on the topic of how to prevent COVID-19 for our staff.
Students' development is a way to initiate and respond to change, supporting and enhancing the design and development of high-quality student learning experiences, facilitating positive change in teaching and learning. It's a process of self-knowledge, learning and personal growth, to make each student to identify their vital values for a better understanding and self-awareness. We have organized some motivational classes and awareness program for the students. These values will define each one's behavior and skill to be developed individually and in group to generate motivation. On the 6th of August 2015, AIDS awareness program conducted by Mrs. P. V. Mahila for 9th and 11th standard students. On the 25th of July 2016, to prevent dengue fever from municipality gave Nilavembu water to our students. On the 22nd of July 2016, we had inaugural function of NICE Education. Mr. Justin was the chief guest, who is the coordinator of NICE Education. On the 6th of October 2016, Mr. Tirumalai Murugan, District Human Rights and founder of Team Trust, conducted competition on the topic of global warming. Six of our students won prizes. On the 11th of January 2017, Road Safety Week observed in our campus by the traffic police from Palayamkottai. Traffic Inspector Mr. Muthuramalingam, SI, Mr. Pandi, and Head Constables Mr. Velmurugan and Mr. Nadarajan were explaining how to follow the traffic rules. On the 22nd of June 2017, regarding NEET examination awareness program conducted by Father J. Seelan, Unreach Academy, for 12th students. On the 6th of September 2018, road safety awareness program was conducted by Scout students to the parents and the school students.
Scouts inauguration and training program. Scouts aims to build and develop young people's confidence, sense of adventure and outdoor skills, as well as encouraging them to explore their beliefs, attitudes and be creative. To motivate our students towards discipline and build positive character, we have started this scout program in our school from 2017-2018.
Staff meetings. The most way of making decisions and motivating staff, we gather our teaching staff every month for meeting, to evaluate the works of the teachers and students and have pre-plan for the next month. Every fourth week of the month, we conduct staff meeting regularly. Parents-teachers meeting. To remind parents that the goal of this meeting is to share information about students' academic progress and growth and how their child interacts in the school environment. All parents are proud of their kids and want to hear about their wards, academic achievements, strengths, and challenges. We conduct parents-teachers meetings on every second Saturday. All the parents will attend and meet their respective staff of their ward and know their performance. They also write their suggestions for the improvement and appreciations in the log note.
Special initiatives. Faith formation is a never-ending process. A process of equipping ourselves to live as disciples of Jesus. Jesus formed his disciples by integrating knowledge about the kingdom of God with practical expressions of living that kingdom. Faith formation is followed in our school by beginning with the school by assembly prayer, meals prayer, class prayer and the ending prayer. Catechism faith formation classes are conducted by the sisters and value education classes are conducted by staff members. Weekly twice we are taking catechism for Christian children and value education for non-Christian children. Through this, we are helping to grow them in holistic level.
Digital learning and teaching. All sorts of teaching aids, charts, models, plug cards, and artificial objects are prepared by the teachers and use it in the classroom. The school imparts digital literacy to all students so that our children will be able to meet the global challenges in the ever-increasing digital world. In every success, there are people behind in all the events. Here, Our administrators and principals, who served for the glory of God and worked hard for the betterment of our students and to bring victory to this institution. We sincerely thank our secretary, Mr. V. William, and all the administrators and principals.
Institutional development. Infrastructure is basic facilities, structures, equipment, technologies, and services that act as the foundation for economic activity and quality of life improvement. To give quality education in this modern world and equip the knowledge in technical learning, we are using digital way of teaching. We feed digital board in 29 classrooms and 32 cameras in each classroom. We constructed a two-floor school building and built a compound wall for the safety of our school. We placed paver block in front of the school ground. Celebrations. Celebrations bring people together and make them more friendly and happy. We share our thoughts and experiences with them. We have national events, family events, religious events and harvest festivals. A festival brings cheerfulness and enthusiasm to the hearts of the people. To know about the meaning of the festivals and make them to understand, we celebrate all the festivals and important events of the leaders of our country. We celebrate Sports Day, Kamarajar Birthday, Independence Day, Teachers Day, Gandhi Jayanti Day, Puja Celebration, Vijayadasami Celebration, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Birthday, Children's Day Celebration, Sales Day, Christmas Day, Pongal Festival and Annual Day.
Sports Day. Sports and games are important for all-round development. They help to shape our personalities. They keep our bodies strong, healthy and fit. It also makes the person with mental and physical toughness by shaping the body and mind. Furthermore, they build character and give a huge amount of energy and strength. Every year we celebrate sports meet in our campus and invite some personalities to encourage our students and to distribute prizes for the winners. The birthday of our former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu and the Kingmaker, Mr. Kamarajar, was celebrated in our school with great reverence. The students of primary, middle and high school performed various programs commemorating the ideals of Kamarajar. Our students delivered a speech in Tamil, followed by a dance by primary students. A Tamil skit was staged by middle school students which brought out the importance of girl education. Every year on the 15th of July, we celebrate the birthday of our former Chief Minister, Kamarajar, as Education Improvement Day.
The Independence Day of India, which is celebrated religiously throughout the country, on the 15th of August every year. On the 15th of August 1947, India got independent from British government. It was witnessing the sacrifices of many freedom fighters who laid down their lives on the line. Every year, we celebrate Independence Day by conducting assembly and hoisting national flag in our school campus. Students are like clay, they can be modified in a way that will make their future bright and meaningful. Dr. Kalam always encouraged students to do better in life through his writings and speeches. The inspirational personality, Dr. Kalam was not just the people's president, but also a teacher, scientist, and professor. His birthday is dedicated to motivate the students to always aim for better in life. World Students Day is celebrated every year on October 15th. On this day, we conduct various competitions and programs to enrich our students. Teachers Day is celebrated on the 5th of September every year to commemorate the birth anniversary of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, the first Vice President of India and the second President of Independent India, and an educationalist at heart. Celebrating Teachers' Day at school is one of the finest memories from the school days. Teachers are the backbone of our society. They spearhead change by shaping and building students' personality and make them ideal citizens of the country. We celebrate Teachers' Day every year on 5th of September. Students perform cultural programs and conduct games to the teachers. Mahatma Gandhi's life has been an inspiration to many because of the life he led. The whole country of India joyfully celebrates Gandhi Jayanti. We celebrate this day on October 2nd by conducting various competitions as essay writing, drawing, and elocution in Tamil and English about Mahatma Gandhi. It is an important day for every Indian.
celebrates Children's Day on 14th of November every year as a tribute to our first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. Thus, we commemorate his birth anniversary as Children's Day. He also stood up for children's education. He shared a lovely bond with children and was very affectionate. We celebrate this day in a grand manner. Especially, KG kids dress up like Jawaharlal Nehru and give speech about Children's Day and Jawaharlal Nehru. We conduct fancy dress competitions on that day and distribute prizes to them. On the event of Children's Day, we conduct different programs like fancy dress competition, elocution, drawing and essay writing. Christmas Day, birth of Jesus Christ is celebrated as Christmas by Christians. But in the school, we all religions will celebrate together as one family. We celebrate it with great joy and happiness. Every year, we celebrate Christmas Day, the first week of December. This day is celebrated in a grand manner in our school. Children perform cultural programs and skit on birth of Jesus Christ. We decorate Christmas trees, sing carol songs and dance as Santa Claus, etc.
Every festival is celebrated with enthusiasm. It also represents our culture. Among other festivals, Pongal is also one of them. It is basically a harvest festival, which is celebrated for 4 days. As we know that India is an agricultural country, and the majority of the festivals are inclined towards nature. It can be considered as the Thanksgiving festival. Every year on 13th of January, we celebrate Pongal Day in our campus. KG students come with colored dress, and we prepare Pongal, and distribute to the students and teachers. Republic Day, the national celebration, is a day ahead. Kids and students are anticipating the celebration with much enthusiasm. This day reminds us of the worth of all our freedom fighters, their sacrifices towards the country's freedom, and their devotion towards the country. So, this day we give our full devotion and respect to them. We celebrate on 26th of January every year by hoisting the national flag, and our principal delivers a speech. At the end, we distribute sweets to the parents, teachers and children.
Annual Day Celebration. At Don Bosco Metric Higher Secondary School, Annual Day is celebrated in a significant manner to showcase our success and our achievements. Every year, one parent is invited as parental guest and they are honored for their support and cooperation in achieving our mission. Celebrating the school Annual Day provides the school with an opportunity to showcase the achievements. This function also gives students opportunity to show their various talents and interact with their teachers in a more informal environment. This is also a day when achievers are felicitated for their accomplishments in the academic year. We celebrate Annual Day in our school with students' colorful events.
KG celebrations. Fruits Day. An apple a day keeps the doctor away, yes. This is quite true as fruits play a very important role in our lives. Fruits along with vegetables have always been very essential in the growth and development of human life. Fruits give us more energy than sugar or sweets. To make our kids to know the importance of fruits, we celebrate Fruits Day every year. Children dress up like fruits and speak about the quality and benefit of each fruit and make the day colorful.
Colors Day. To organize colors and show their relationship to each other, we celebrate Colors Day in our school. To make the kids to identify the different colors and explain the meaning of each color to the children. Green Day, Red Day, and Yellow Day were celebrated with great zeal and enthusiasm in the pre-primary wing of our school in various occasions. Our kids came to school dressed in pretty green and red color attires and looked eco-friendly. Children brought plants and trees to plant in our campus. All the important days are celebrated to create unity among the children. KG students are encouraged to participate in all the events.
Vegetable Day. The Fruit and Vegetable Day was aimed at educating children about the importance of fruits and vegetables. Eating vegetables every day is important for health. We celebrate Fruits and Vegetables Day every year. Children were dressed as vegetables and fruits. They speak about the importance of vegetables. Teachers explain them about the uses of and importance of fruits and vegetables, and where they grow. The pre-primary teachers together prepare tasty and delicious fruit salad and distribute to the children. Children also participate in the competition of identifying the different types of vegetables and fruits.
Shapes Day. The ability to accurately identify shapes is a foundational mathematical skill. Teachers teach them the basic shapes, how a child incorporate a knowledge of shapes into their life, and to create original works of art using the shapes. To bring out the hidden talents of our kids, we conduct this competition.
Animals Day. Animals have great importance in our lives. The day dedicated to animals, for making people aware of the world, about the role of animals in our lives. World Animal Day is a global observance day, celebrated on the 4th of October. We must show our gratitude towards animals and their contributions in our life by putting an end to animal cruelty. We celebrate Animals Day every year on the 4th of October. Our kids come with animal dress and they introduce themselves with the name of the animal.
Co-curricular and club activities. In addition to the regular education, we are providing co-curricular and extracurricular activities. Clubs were formed to strengthen their education. All the important days are celebrated to create unity among the children, to increase thinking capacity of our students, and to make them to bring out their innovative ideas. We conduct various club activities and associations like Tamil Literary Association, English Literary Associations, Parents and Teachers Association, Mathematics Club, Science Club, Social Clubs and Life Skill Education also given to the students.
Tamil Literary Association. Tamil Literary Association's aim at creating a love for the language and a passion to acquire higher order skills such as creative communication through the media of prose, poetry, and drama. The students learn to appreciate Tamil history and culture well through this club. In order to improve the language skills, we used to conduct 6-language program in term-wise every year. Students represent various competitions. These activities are well integrated with the curriculum to help students in higher academic achievements.
The aim of our school is focusing on the improvement of reading, writing, speaking and listening skills of the students in our school. Our vision is to make the Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School as a full-fledged English medium school and English-speaking campus. Language is the medium of instruction through which educational process fulfills its aims. We are conducting a number of activities and competitions throughout the year to improve the study skills and language skills of the students. Students play and act dramas, read poems, and cultural events. Through their good performance, they bring their hidden talents and improve their communication skills. Special awards and achievements from the year 2015-20. A milestone is a significant event in the history or development of something or someone. We are delighted to share that, in the year 1999, the first batch students appeared for SSLC, public examination. Our school has upgraded to higher secondary during the academic year 2013-14. From the beginning of our establishment, we are producing centum results continuously in both SSLC and higher secondary public board examinations. We are very proud to say that our school got state second rank in the year 2013-14. Master P. Arun Kumar, who secured 498 out of 500 in 10th standard public examination. On the 23rd of January 2017, Principal and Administrator went to Tirunelveli and received Shield for producing centum results in 10th standard public examinations in the year 2015-16. Shield was given by Tirunelveli District Collector.
Awareness programs. Awareness is like the sun, when it shines on things, they are transformed. Various awareness programs were conducted like dengue awareness, AIDS awareness, health awareness, road safety awareness, tuberculosis awareness, and COVID-19 awareness, for the betterment of the students, of by which to construct and focus their mind purely, in academic and other developmental areas. Tirunelveli Corporation has organized a awareness program on prevention of dengue fever. From 2017 onwards, 5 days in a month, government staff from municipality, were giving Nilavembu Kashayam for all the students in our school. A child who learns about traffic rules and road discipline will grow up to be a law-abiding citizen. The habit of obeying traffic rules teaches a person a sense of responsibility, empathy for others, and respecting the other person's rights. On the 11th of January 2017, Road Safety Awareness Program was conducted for the students.
On the 12th of February 2016, Tuberculosis Eradication Day was celebrated by conducting meetings and processions by carrying banners and chanting slogans. On the 16th of January 2018, AIDS Awareness Program was conducted for the parents and teachers. On 13th of March 2020, COVID-19 Awareness Program was conducted in our school campus for the staff by our principal Mr. C. Manikkar Raj. Our teachers motivated our children about corona and how to prevent them from this virus. They taught them about washing the hands often and follow social distance.
Physical education. Physical exercise promotes positive self-image, high productivity and energetic well-being. Physical fitness can be a key component of a healthy lifestyle. The students also retain a higher level of knowledge on health. Physical education helps to improve the academic performance of a student. It increases their higher levels of concentration on studies. Along with other subjects, we give importance for physical education. To increase confidence, mental alertness, and to stay healthy, we conduct physical education every day, and annual sports meet every year.
Achievements in sports. On the 12th of February 2009, World Beaters Talent Sporting Scheme has organized sports competition in Anna Stadium, Palayamkottai. Our students got 3 first place in long jump and 2 second place in shot put. On the 20th of July 2009, zonal sports meet was conducted in Muslim Higher Secondary School, Tirunelveli. Our boys and girls won second place in ball badminton. On the 16th of August 2009, our students participated in throw ball competition in St. Thomas School, Kurichi and won first place. On the 9th of July 2010, zonal meet sports and held in Shankar Nagar, Tirunelveli. Our students participated in ball badminton and won first place. On the 17th of August 2016, our students participated in junior and senior ball badminton zonal match and they won first prize. On the 17th of October 2018, divisional match in ball badminton for senior boys held in Ettipuram. 9 of our students took part in the match and won second prize. Inter-school sports meet was held at DMI St. Global School, Yagapuram on 11th of February 2020 in the presence of our founder and chairman Reverend Father Dr. J. A. Arulraj.
Competitions. Through competitions, students gain better understanding of how to deal with conflicting opinions and ideas to help students and increase their respect for academics and bring their hidden talents also to make them to know their potentialities. We conduct various competitions like speech in Tamil and English, essay writing in Tamil and English, drawing on different topics, rangoli, quiz competitions, art from waste and fancy dress competition for primary students.
Interview for teachers. On 14th of March 2020, we have conducted interview for teachers in our campus. Mr. V. William, our secretary, the principal from RLY Moji, and Don Bosco, administrators of the schools, were in the interview. From Rajapalayam School, Tenkasi Global School, and RLY Moji CBSE Global School, and Don Bosco Matriculation Higher Secondary School. Totally 45 candidates were attended in the interview for all 4 schools. Canvassing program. The more admissions, the more success. Every year from the month of February, our teachers go for door-to-door canvassing program. Inspection. On 16th of March 2018, from Educational Management Information System, checking inspector visited our school. On the 1st of September 2020, our DO, Mrs. Renuka Devi, visited our school for the renewal of our recognition. On the 28th of October 2020, our CEO Mr. Senthil Nathan visited our school for the renewal of our recognition. Education through online. Since this COVID-19 significantly disturbed the higher education sector, we started taking online classes to the students. According the guidelines of DFT and principal, our teachers take classes and send daily and weekly report to DFT. The primary benefit of online learning involves scheduling flexibility. This enables to reach out to the students more efficiently and effectively through chat groups, video meetings, and sharing. This online learning was more effective to get the full benefit. This advantage of online learning allows students to work in the environment. It helps to develop self-discipline and responsibility.
DFT monitoring programs and visits. The primary purpose of in-service training is to enable teachers to acquire new understanding and instructional skills. It focuses on creating learning environments which enable teachers to develop their effectiveness in the classroom. To equip knowledge and skills among our teachers, DFT organize many training programs for our teachers.
Sister K. Rosalyn, our correspondent, visited our school and met all our supportive staff and teaching staff. She had conducted meeting with the staff. She also went few classes to meet children. She had conducted meeting for the teaching staff and explained about our society and rules and regulations of DFT group of schools.
Major superiors visit. Many dignitaries visited our school in various occasions. Concession. We sincerely thank our father founder for his generous heart. Every year, our father founder grant concession generously to educate the poor children. Past 15 years from 2005 to 2020. Totally 793 students were benefited with the amount of ₹31,71,285.
All for the greater glory of God. We thank God the Almighty for His benevolent blessing. We are very grateful to our Mother Virgin, who always supports us by her prayer, for the growth and development of our mission. We extend our heartfelt gratitude to Reverend Father Dr. J. A. Arul Raj, founder and chairman of DMI and AMMI group of institutions, Reverend Sister C. Rita, DMI the Superiors General, Reverend Sister Gyana Selvam, the DFT Managing Trustee, Reverend Sister Jehani, the Secretary of DFT Groups of Schools, Reverend Sister L. Xavier Selvi, the Southern Provincial, the former Provincials Reverend Sister Victoria and Malar Jyothi, and Reverend Sister Rosalind the Correspondent, for their great support and guidance towards the growth of our institution. We thank DFT for upgrading with latest technology and teaching aids and providing all the materials to satisfy the students and parents. Our sincere thanks to our Secretary Mr. V. William, Principal Mr. C. Manikkar Raj and all our teaching staff for their tireless support to produce centum result in all these years. We also remember and thank all the superiors, administrators and sisters who rendered their service for this mission. Once again, we thank you one and all.